Do the exercise number 2 in control account. Read this sum. Following transaction extracted from a business for the year 2016 January, debtors balance debit 62,000, debtors balance credit 1,000, credit sales 1 lakh. Cash received from debtors 20,000. Bad debts 2,000. Bad debt received 500. Interest charged 750. Set off against creditors. Sales return 12,000. Check received 30,000. Discount allowed 4,000. Allowances allowed 1,000. Check received dishonored 12,000. Debtors brought forward 31st 1 2016, credit balance 500. Right, so we have to prepare the debtors control account. Right, take a worksheet like this. Right, control account. Right, say it is debtors control account. So write it here, debtors control account. Debtors control account. Debtors control account. Right. Now write the transaction given. Opening balance. Yeah, debtors 2016 January 1st, balance debit balance 62,000, credit balance 1,000. Right, show that here. Brought forward balance 62,000, credit balance 1,000. Then next, credit sales 100,000. So record the credit sale in the debit side of the debtors control account. Because of the credit sales, debtors increasing. Then sales return 12,000. Right, by sales return debtors decreasing, so you have to record it in the credit side of the debtors control account, 12,000. Right, next, cash received from debtors 20,000. Cash received from debtors 20,000. So if we received cash from the debtors, debtors will decrease. So debtors will decrease. So cash received should be recorded in the credit side of the debtors control account. Right, next, check received 30,000. Right, by receiving check, also the debtors balance decreasing. So write that in the credit side of the debtors control account. Right, next, check received. Okay, then bad debts. Right, bad debts. By bad debts, debtors decreasing. By bad debts, debtors decreasing. So you have to write it in the credit side of the debtors control account. Right. Next, discount allowed. Right, if we allow discount to debtors, the receivable amount from debtors decreasing. So you have to write it in the credit side of the debtors control account. Right, next, bad debts received. Bad debt received mean already bad debts occurred and it has write off from the debtors. Now if we received that write off bad debts again, actually that is an income. So double entry for bad debt received. When receiving money, we have to record it. No, yeah, when receiving money, we have to record as cash account debit, debtors control account credit, because one of debtor no giving that money, so debtors control account credit, right? Now this is a cash receiving entry. Now this cash received is actually an income, because this bad debts is already written off. So if we, that means if already written off, that we shown that as a loss, right? If we receiving that money, the write off bad of debts, if we receive again, it is an income. So you have to write it now, debtors control account debit, because already we credit to debtors control account. No, when we receiving money, we credit to debtors control account. Now you cancel it by debiting debtors control account and credit to bad debt received account. Yeah, so this is the double entry for the bad debts received. So if you check this double entries, a debit entry in the debtors control account and a credit entry in the debtors control account entry is arising. So we have to write in both side of the debtors control account. When you writing this, bad debt received should be recorded in the debit side and credit side also. Bad debt received, you have to record in the credit side also. So that 500 bad debt received, you have to record in both side, debit and credit. Right, next, bad debt received. Okay, allowances allowed. Allowances allowed. So if we allowed any special allowances, debtors receiving amount, receivable debtors amount will decrease. So allowances allowed should be recorded in the credit side, because that will decrease the debtors. Right. Next, interest charge. Interest charge will increase the debtors. So if a debtor not paid the payable amount in time, on those time we are charging the interest on debt amount. So when charging debt amount, when charging interest on debt amount, the debt amount will increase. So you have to record it in the debit side. Interest charge should be recorded in the debit side. Next, check received dishonored. Right, if check received dishonored, we have to record it in the debit side. Why? Because when receiving check, that will decrease the debtors, so we would have credited when receiving check. But if the received check is dishonored, again the debtors will increase, so you have to write it in the debit side. Next, set off again creditors. Set off again creditors mean sometime debtor would be a creditor in the same organization. So we can set off the receivable amount against to payable amount. So we can deduct the debtors, and this deducting amount can be decreased from the payable amount. So by set off, debtors decreasing. Right. Next, debtors brought forward balance 31/1/2016 500. That is mean end of the month balance. End of the month balance, credit side balance. So you have to record it that here. End of the month balance, credit balance mean brought forward should be in the credit side. So this brought forward comes from this side. So you have to write here carry down balance 500. Right. That's all. Now we record all the transaction in the debtors control account. I think you would have understand when recording the transaction, what are the transaction which increased the debtors had record in the debit side. What are the transaction that increased the debtors that was recorded in the debit side? What are the transaction that will decrease the debtors was recorded in the credit side? So it is easier to keep it in your mind when you preparing debtors control account. What will be increase the credit debtor that should be recorded in the debit side, and what will be decrease the debtor that should be recorded in the credit side. So after recording this transaction, you get the total of the debit side first, because debtor is asset, no? So usually debtors balance debit side is more. So get the total of debit side and put that total in the credit side. Then from this total, you deduct all this amount. Deduct all this amount. And if you deduct all this amount, you can get the carried down balance 92,500 and take that as brought forward. That's all. So I am going to wind up this lesson. You also do the sum and check whether you can get this answer.